Day five of our fish dissection. This is kind of the beginning of the grand finale. This is where it really gets good. So we've studied the ears and the eyes and the gills and the fins. Now it's time to really get into the internal organs on this fish. And there's a lot to see. So let's get going. When we open up the body cavity on our perch to find all the internal organs, we're going to start back here at the vent. We're going to slide our scissors right in the vent and start cutting. And right now we're just cutting through skin, so it's pretty easy. As soon as we get up to where these pelvic fins are, there's a layer of bone there, and it's going to get hard. We're going to have to kind of crunch our way through that bone, and we are going to keep cutting all the way up between the gills of the fish, see what we can find. So now we've got the only cut made. We're going to pry things open, and we will look initially at the internal organs inside of the fish. First thing we see right on top, we're going to move out of the way, is this tube that runs from the digestive system of the fish in front back here to the vent. That is the large intestine. That's the end of the digestive tract. When the food is all used up in the fish, it passes out of the body as fish poop right out the vent. So we're just going to cut that off so we can work our way around this, because the next thing we're going to look for underneath here, see this big kind of purple-orangish lump. This tells us right away, we know this perch was a female and these are her eggs. So we can get those eggs out of there. If we grab the eggs, it'll give us a lot more room to work with. All that really holds them in place are a few little arteries and veins. We can take those eggs out in one clump. And we're not going to count them now, but I would guess if we look closely at here, there might be 3,000 or 4,000 or 5,000 eggs. They're tiny, they're very small, but lots of them. And a perch this size might lay 5,000 eggs every single year. So we will set those eggs aside in one big egg mass over there, and we will move our attention up a little bit closer to the front of the perch. And I need to open this up a little bit more, because way up here between the gills, not the easiest thing to see, but this little red lump up here, shaped almost like a little triangle, is the fish's heart. So the heart is way up here. There's a chamber on top, chamber on the bottom. If we grab this by the top, by the arteries and veins that come into the top of the heart, if we're careful, we should be able to just take that heart, split a little bit, but that is our perch's heart right there. So these are the arteries and veins. Here's the heart. We will set the fish's heart off to the side. And we're going to keep going. So now some of the organs are out. There's still a few things left in here, the important stuff. The digestive system, the way the food works through the fish. Covering all of the digestive system is this big pink organ. That's the liver. And the liver produces fluids. They're called enzymes. And they help the fish digest its food when it is down here into the fish's stomach, which is kind of hidden underneath all of this down here. Here's our fish's stomach. We have to kind of pick our way through all these. It's a muscular organ. To actually get food into the stomach starts up here in the mouth, and there's a tube called the esophagus. And if I slide my tweezers down there, hard to control all this, but if I slide the tweezers down, it'll go right down the fish's esophagus, all the way down here into the bottom, and out here is the fish's stomach, and there's the end of my tweezers. So that's the fish's stomach, which is covered by the liver. The food starts digesting when it's in the stomach, passes through the stomach into the intestines, which is this whole mass right here, through the small intestines first. That's where the nutrients from the food is absorbed into the fish's body. And then whatever waste, like we said, the fish poop, travels down the large intestine and leaves right here through the fish's vent. If we move this out of the way, actually we're just going to cut all of these organs out. Give us a nice clear view inside of the fish. There are some neat things to go inside of here. We'll get rid of some of the blood from the fish, some of the liquid that's in there. And you see this shiny layer of, almost looks like skin. It's a membrane inside of the fish. And what that's called is the fish's air bladder. And what would you guess happens to be inside of an air bladder? What do you think it's full of? Air, right? Makes sense. Why would a fish want air inside of its body? What does air do in the water? It floats. So the air bladder, if we pop through this, is just a hollow tube. It kind of deflates right now. You can see it's a hollow tube inside of there that was full of air, and that helps the fish float in the water. Without an air bladder, fish would just sink right down to the bottom like a big rock. If you can look underneath the air bladder, there is a little red line that runs right along the backbone of the fish. The solid red line, and that's something that a fish has that's much different from a human. This red line is the fish's kidney. So if you know about humans or mammals, we have two kidneys. They're small and they're round, about the size of your fist. We can take kidneys out of people. They're easy to grab onto in there. In a fish, this long, flat kidney is not easy to get out. We can't take it out. We can't show you. So you just have to look at it right here. And as I run my finger along this fish's kidney, the kidney's in there to filter out. It filters the blood of the fish, takes the waste out, and produces the waste from the blood is called urine. That also drains out of the fish through its vent. But as I'm running my finger along the kidney, I am feeling all kinds of bones in there, the spine, the ribs. All of those are inside of the fish. They're not easy to see, but here's the disadvantage to doing a dissection this way. They're easy for me to feel, but you can't feel them, but they're there. All of the white material on the inside of the fish is muscle. So the fish's whole body then would be covered with muscle right underneath the skin inside of the abdominal cavity here. That's what moves the fish. The muscle is also the part that we're going to eat when we eat fish. We're not going to eat this one, but if you like to eat fish, what you're actually eating there is the muscle. So again, we got bones, we have muscles, we have kidneys, we have air bladders, stomachs, intestines, all kinds of neat stuff inside of the fish. It's a lot to look at in one short little segment, but we did it, and now all that's left is to look for the brain inside of the fish. So that will be our last task, our last thing to do with this fish, and we will see you next time when we find the fish's brain.